do. We have Tim Walz, Governor of the great state of Minnesota. Thank you for being with us today. Proud to be with you. And Tim, a lot of your career has been spent in education. And you have an announcement for us today that relates to students.
We do. Well, good afternoon, everyone. I'm really proud to be here. You're going to hear from a couple of our leaders in two great organizations, FFA and 4-H. And many of you in this room are alumni. Yes. Me included, but my blue jacket does not fit anymore, but we all would keep the lessons from that. Well, a lot of young folks got together understanding how important this organization is, and they went to the state legislature. They worked with Senator Tom, Senator Newman, and others, and they had a proposal to make sure that we get a funding stream to help these organizations. And so today, we're really proud to announce, you're going to get a chance to see this, and then they're going to talk a little bit about some opportunities for some of you. State of Minnesota, starting next year, we'll have a specialized license plate for FFA and 4-H. Proceeds go back to the organizations, and I think the design, you guys want to say something about that?
Yeah. Go right ahead, pal.
I'll speak to the design a little bit. So first off, thank you for all being here and helping us celebrate this really special day. So today we're announcing a contest where active FFA and 4-H members can submit designs that can inspire the license plate, which will be available in early 2022. And so for all those contest details, you'll want to visit the Minnesota FFA Foundation or the Minnesota 4-H Extension website. And we encourage all of you who have FFA and 4-H members to get those designs submitted by October 1st, so our commissioners have a good variety to choose from.
Well, that is great. And we've got a couple, why don't we have those young people, you can be the farm broadcaster here. I have to go over there and visit with them a little bit. There you go.
All right. Well, these are two leaders in the organizations that made this happen. I want to have them say a few words about it and what it meant to them. If you two would just introduce yourselves, tell us where you're going to school now, what you're studying, and how you got involved in the organization you represent.
Hello everyone, my name is Caitlin Lorraine and I am from Morton, Minnesota right here. That's in Renville County, and I've been a 4-H'er for 13 years and I am currently attending SDSU where I will be a sophomore this fall, majoring in Ag Communications and a minor in agronomy. And I kind of got started in 4-H through my younger years with both of my parents and my older cousins, older 4-H members. And I've been really involved in all of the agronomy projects, plant and soil sciences. And I think 4-H has really had a profound impact on my public speaking skills. It's brought me right here some really amazing opportunities through 4-H and also FFA. I was an FFA member as well since 7th grade, so kind of both roles as well.
Yeah. All right.
Hello everyone, my name is Emily Mateka and I'm currently serving as Minnesota FFA State President. I'm originally from the Sherburne, Minnesota area. Martin County West is my home chapter, and I'm currently attending South Dakota State University, also majoring in Ag Communications along with Kate. So we're besties at SDSU and also FFA besties as well. We kind of grew up in that FFA world together. Starting my FFA journey in 7th grade, it really got me interested in that agricultural industry. I grew up on my family's farm, so I had a background in agriculture, but I really wanted to take it further. And so joining FFA was a little bit of a no-brainer, but it really didn't show what I could learn until later as I got more comfortable being a leader, more comfortable public speaking, and it really brought me out of my shell to be the leader that I am today.
And Governor, it's amazing how good of speakers these young people are and what they learn from leadership.
Well, those of us who know, who served in or had the opportunity to be in these organizations, that's part of what they teach. This is about leadership, whether they're coming directly from the farm, agribusiness, or they're going to be involved in any of the peripheral industries. So I can tell you, we want you to get in those designs, get this license plate, and just, I will note, we fixed that Minlarge thing so you will get them in less than 6 months if you order them. And you'll get them sooner than that. So get in, the money goes back to these organizations. And as you can see, this is our leadership coming forward. These organizations do incredible work about all the rest of the sponsors really manage.
Okay, we're gonna take a break. About another round of applause for the Governor Rick Warren. We'll be back in a minute.